So in this question, it says, for what value of n is the absolute value of the quantity n minus 1 plus 1 equal to 0? So the answer choices are 0, positive 1, positive 2, or there is no such value of n. So just recall that the absolute, to me there's not much to do in this problem as long as you remember absolute value. So remember, if you take the absolute value of a number, you know, so the absolute value of 0 is 0. You can think about it as being a distance from a number, you know, the distance from 0 on the number line. That's some way people think about it. I always just think of it, you know, if the number's already positive, you leave it alone. So, for example, the absolute value of 2 would be 2. If the number's negative, the absolute value of negative 4, again, we just drop the negative sign. So the absolute value of negative 4 is positive 4. The main thing to remember is that the absolute value is always going to give you either, after you simplify, it's either going to be a number that's 0 or larger. So just based on that, I know that the absolute value of n minus 1, no matter what value I substitute in for n, this absolute value is always going to give me a number that is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so I'm going to get something that's 0 or larger. Well, if I add 1 to that, again, if I add 1 to that value, it's going to give me a number that's greater than or equal to 1. So in this case, there would be no such value of n. And again, you could check, you know, if you substitute in 0, you would have 0 minus 1, which would be negative 1. The absolute value of negative 1 is positive 1, so you'd have positive 1 plus 1. If you substitute in 0, you'll actually get the value of 2. If you substitute in n equals 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, the absolute value is 0, of 0 is 0, plus 1 would give you 1 as a value. And if you substitute in the value of 2, well, 2 minus 1 is 1, the absolute value is still 1, plus 1, it'll actually again give you the value of 2. So if you substitute in 0, you get 2. If you substitute in 1, you get 1. If you substitute in, you get 2. Again, we're trying to get 0 out. So there's no such value of n in this case. You know, they could give you some really wonky problem. You know, they could make it like n squared plus n raised to the 400th power minus the square root of pi, plus, you know, 8 to the 8 to the 8 plus 1, you know, what value of n? They could ask you the same question. For what value of n is this quantity equal to 0? Same thing. There'll be no solution because no matter what you substitute in for n, the absolute value, again, you're going to get something that's 0 or larger. Hey, if you add 1 to that, it's going to give you something that's 1 or larger. So that's all there is to it, just making sure that you remember absolute value. So, you know, hopefully if you saw this on the SAT, this would be a pretty quick question, and you could just, you know, circle answer choice D and keep on trucking.